Hello, my dear students. How are you? I am Professor H.R. Saini. I am with you with a new topic. And today's topic is Law of Conservation of Momentum. Statement of the law. The law of conservation of momentum states that the total momentum of a system remains constant unless an external force is applied on it. Iska matlab kya banta hai? कि आपके पास कोई आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम है जब तक हम उस पर बाहर से कोई फोर्स नहीं अप्लाई करेंगे तब तक उसका टोटल मोमेंटम जो है दैट विल रिमेन द सेम एंड दिस लॉ इज वन ऑफ द फंडामेंटल लॉज इन फिजिक्स एंड सो फार देयर हैज बीन नो सिचुएशन इन विच दिस लॉ हैज बीन वायोलेटेड नाउ आई कम टू द प्रूफ ऑफ दिस लॉ सपोज Two bodies A and B of masses m1 and m2 and moving with velocities u1 and u2 are moving in the same direction along a straight path. So before collision, the mass of the body A is m1, its velocity is u1. So its momentum is m1 u1. And that of body B is m2 into u2. So therefore, total momentum before collision is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. Then, if we assume that the velocity of the body B is more than that of A, then after some time, the body B will collide with body A. So therefore, there will be a collision. And during collision, the body B will exert a force on the body A in the forward direction. Let this force be F1. Then F1 is the action of body A, action of body B, action of body B on body A, body B on body A. And the body A will exert an equal and opposite reaction on the body B. So if F2 is the action or reaction of the body A on body B, reaction of body A on body B, then according to Newton's third law of motion, F2 equal to minus F1. Now, let us prove that the total momentum before collision, that is M1 U1 plus M2 U2, is total momentum after collision. And after collision, let the velocity of body A be V1 and that of body B be V2. Therefore, total momentum after collision is M1 V1 plus M2 V2. So, this is the situation after collision. This is the situation during collision and this is a situation before collision. Now, F1, that is the force acting on the body A due to the body B, equal to M1 into A1, because according to Newton's second law of motion, force is mass into acceleration, and this is equal to M1. A1 is acceleration, and you know that acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. So, the change in velocity of body A is V1 minus U1. V1 is the velocity after collision and U1 is the velocity of the body A before collision. And suppose the time for which the collision takes place, that is the time of collision, is T, then rate of change of velocity, that is acceleration of the body A, is V1 minus U1 over T. And F2 equal to M2 into A2. And this will be equal to M2 into acceleration of the body B. That is change in velocity of body B, which is V2 minus U2. Over time, and the time of collision is T. So this is the, let us call this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. Now, according to Newton's third law of motion, as I told you earlier, F2 must be equal to minus F1, or you can say that, now what is F2? F2 is M2 into V2 minus U2 divided by T, and this is equal to minus M1 into V1 minus U1 divided by T. Now this T goes with this T, and I am left with M2 V2 minus M2 U2, or you can say that M2 V2, M2 V2 minus M2 U2 equal to, on the right hand side, I will have this equal to minus M1 V1 plus M1 U1 minus M1 V1 plus M1 U1. So this is equal to minus M1 V1 plus M1 U1, or I will bring this M1 V1 on left hand side, this will become positive. So or M1 V1 plus M2 V2, this will be equal to M1 U1 is there on the right hand side, and I will take this M2 U2 negative on the other side, it will come plus M2 U2. Now this is the total momentum after collision, and this is the total momentum before collision. So therefore we have proved that total momentum after collision equal to total momentum before collision, and that is the law of conservation of momentum. As I told you, this is a fundamental law in physics and is used in many numerical problems. So please keep in mind that unless we apply an external force on an isolated system, the total momentum remains the same before collision. Now we come to some examples of conservation of momentum, the law of conservation of momentum. First is, suppose a man jumps from a boat onto the bank of a river. What will happen? As the man jumps out of the boat will move in the backward direction. Aisa kyun hoga? Because the forward momentum of the man is equal to the backward momentum of the boat. So therefore, the motion of the boat in the backward direction as the man jumps out of it onto the bank of the river is very much in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum. Then the second example is the motion of gun and bullet. Suppose we have a gun whose mass is capital M, motion of gun and bullet. Motion of gun and bullet. We have a gun whose mass is capital M. Now, when the bullet is fired from this gun, the bullet will move in the forward direction and the gun will recoil or move in the backward direction. The velocity with which the gun moves in the backward direction is called velocity of recoil of the gun, and it is in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum, because the forward momentum of the bullet must be equal to the backward momentum of the gun. Now suppose mass of the gun is capital M, mass of the bullet is small m. Therefore, before firing, because both the gun as well as the bullet are at rest, therefore total momentum before firing, total momentum before firing, total momentum before firing equal to zero, because the momentum of both is zero, equal to zero. Now if v is the velocity of the bullet, small v, then momentum of the bullet after firing equal to small m into small v. And if capital V is the velocity of recoil of the gun, then momentum of the gun is capital M into capital V. Therefore, total momentum after firing equal to capital MV, this is the momentum of the gun, plus small MV, this is the momentum of the bullet. But according to the law of conservation of momentum, the total momentum of the system is the gun and the bullet, after firing must be equal to its total momentum before firing, that is capital MV plus small MV, this must be equal to zero. Or you can say that capital MV equal to minus small MV, or capital V equal to minus small MV divided by capital M. So that gives us the velocity of recoil of the gun. This negative sign shows that the direction of capital V, that is the velocity of the gun, is opposite to that of the direction of small V, that is the speed of or velocity of the bullet. So therefore, as the bullet moves in the forward direction, gun recoils in the backward direction. Now, for given values of small m and small v, kyunki bullet ka mass fix hai, jitni velocity se kisi gun se hum usko fire kar sakte hain, wo bhi fix hai. That means small m into small v is constant for given values of m and v. So this equation leads us to the conclusion that capital V proportional to 1 over m, inversely proportional to mass of the gun. That means heavier the gun, lesser is the velocity of recoil, and vice versa. So, agar gun halki hogi, to uski velocity of recoil zyada hogi, aur agar gun heavy hogi, to uski velocity of recoil kam hogi. Isi tarah aur examples ho sakti hain. The motion of a jet aeroplane. Aapne dekha hoga ki jet aeroplane jab chalta hai, to usme se jab fuel burn karta hai, to gases bahut speed se move karti hain in the backward direction, and the jet aeroplane moves in the forward direction. It is also in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum, because the forward backward momentum of the gases must be equal to the forward momentum of the jet aeroplane. Similarly, the working of a rocket is also based upon the law of conservation of momentum. Aapne dekha hoga jab rocket daagte hain to usme se gases badi speed se piche ki taraf aati hain aur rocket upar ki taraf move karta hai. So the momentum of the rocket in the upward direction is equal to the momentum of the gases in the downward direction. And that is all for today. I hope you must have enjoyed my lecture. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.